Hi everybody, welcome to Making Australia the Crafter Show, where we're going to be recapping every episode of this season of Making It Australia. I'm crochet artist Chilly Philly, and every week I'm joined by a new fun crochet guest. And this week I'm joined by fellow crocheter, Crochet Mizadi, aka Zac. Woo!
Hello! Happy to be here.
So for those who don't know what you do, tell us all about your crochet work.
Well, I crochet dolls, quite clearly. I started doing this about probably 2 years ago. I started crocheting like the little granny squares for about 4 years. And I always wanted to make a giant blanket or even like making like jumpers that you make. And then eventually I just kind of stepped away from anything that was like clothing or flat and really wanted to make cute little things. And so I actually made this whole like online profile in lockdown when everything kicked off. And it's just been a wild ride since. And now since then I've gotten a bit of a following on TikTok, Instagram, and do live streaming on Twitch with people come join me and craft together. So super fun, super cool, and making cute things.
So obviously you're in New Zealand, so you haven't gotten to, you know, watch the whole show, but you did tune in for this episode. What were your sort of initial thoughts so far?
So I mean, I watch a lot of reality TV, so I was expecting like a show where people are going head to head, battling it out with whatever kind of creativity they've got, what kind of skills they've got, using what they have in front of them and just trying to apply that to the challenges. And that's essentially what I got. So it was pretty cool to see.
Yeah, it's kind of really interesting because when I found out what this episode was going to be about, I realized that you probably would be a very good guest for it because the theme for this week's episode is all about random acts of kindness. And for the Faster Craft, the makers were asked to create a soft toy for a child, which both of us have experience with making sort of soft toys and soft things. What did you think of what everybody got to do?
So when I saw this challenge coming up, all I was thinking in my head is like at the moment I've got my sister who's meant to be moving back to Australia lately, and she's got the nephew here as well. And so I've been making a lot of dolls just to entertain the nephew. And so all I was thinking in my mind is what was the kind of end result that they're going to come up with, and whether a little baby or a small child would be able to interact with it and have fun with it, and yeah, if it was the right thing for them, I guess.
Yeah. Who were your favorites?
Favorites? I wrote down a lot of notes. My favorites were definitely George with the dinosaur helicopter Godzilla moment. I thought that was very cool, very creative, lots of textures, lots of colors, and very kind of like, I guess it's like child focus when you bring in like the dinosaurs and things. And I really liked Rizaldi's with the little, was it like a worm?
It was just like a being.
the little bean character with the interchangeable clothes and things. I thought that was very cute and a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's almost like they all each had a variation of a good soft toy. Like you had, you know, Jax had all the different textures, so it was a very much a stimulus sort of being.
Yeah.
Then you had Rahana's was a very practical one. It had the, you could hide your blanket in it. And then you had Will's, which had the chair, which they seemed to really like.
I was saying as soon as I saw Will making the felt bear, I was like, and he said it's the first time he's made a bear like that. It took me back to doing textiles in early high school, where you get to make a bear for the first time. And I was like, oh no, this is a bit the assignment.
But then speaking of Will, he wins the Mastercraft, which is actually to make a gift for a loved one who actually happened to have also came in. Who were some of your favorites out of the gifts?
I personally love the wild and wacky ones. So I was a big fan of Rihanna's. Yeah. I loved it. Like, what a gift. Like, to kind of like think about, you're making it for your partner and you're like, well, what else do they love most?
Yeah.
Me. So going ahead and making a giant beanbag of yourself, I was cackling.
I really like George's just because it was like a full-on artwork. Like, it, I don't know how you could use it in a practical way, because unless you sit like cross-legged on it, but it was definitely an art piece. Like, it really was visually amazing.
Yeah, that was the thing I was thinking about these, is I was kind of going in thinking about like the practicality of them all. And so that's why when I was, what's his name? The little house.
Jack.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking it was like a cat house.
Yeah. I feel like there was a real missed opportunity to have shots of Jack's partner getting in it and on it.
Was it for her?
Yeah. she was matching color wise to it. They kind of just stood next to it and stared at it. But then, speaking of like practicality, like I feel like the real practical one was Rizaldi's, which it was nice, but I kind of wish it had more than just a function.
Yeah, like it was probably the most functional gift. I was gonna say, I remember when I was younger, my parents, they kind of gifted me like a wardrobe closet thing. They're like, now you can put your clothes in there. And I was like, yay.
Yeah. And then of course, Will wins the challenge with his nice little metal work rose. What did you think of that?
I mean, it was gorgeous. Like, hands down, well made, detailed, just very cool. It was just very cool.
It was just really funny, and I said it to you before, but when they kept holding it, it really looked like a scepter. Like, it really looked like they were crowning someone that night. And it happened to be Will, but like, his girlfriend was really like, oh, this object is beautiful. Well, thank you everybody for joining me for this week's craft show. Join me again next week for another one. And until then, keep crafting. Bye.
Bye.